my likes about this job is that I can drive around the majority of the time, and that during summer at least, there's a lot of free time, so sometimes there'll be a lot of people calling me on my phone for help, and there'll be sometimes I'll be by myself, and it'll be stressful sometimes. So I guess that's one of the dislikes.
What is your most favorite part about?
My favorite part about being a reporter is that I have help the majority of the time, and I have fun the majority of the time. Sometimes salesmen, they will buy me food, which is good and cool. And I also, on holidays, would get double pay, which is also good.
Is salary enough for you to be stable?
Salary, well, living by myself, it's not going to be stable. Living with family, yes, kind of. I'm going to college as of right now, so to answer the question, no. It's 50-50. Majority of the time, I do work with co-workers. I have 4 other co-workers with me. But some days, there will be times where all of them call off and I just call myself. So it really just depends on what day it is.
Is there any danger involved?
Yes, there's actually a lot of danger. There's been a couple occurrences where I'll be driving and somebody will be driving really fast on the street and I'll almost get in a car crash. Or a pedestrian would be crossing the street and I'd almost hit them because either I wasn't looking or they ran across the street really fast.
Alright. Who inspired you to be a reporter?
It was both my uncle and my dad. My dad told me about this job. He said that there was an opening position, and before, I used to work at McDonald's, which, yeah, right now, but my uncle and my dad, they told me that there was a position open, and I took it, and it's way easier than my first job, so I'm probably good.
Any paperwork involved?
Yes, there is paperwork every once in a while. There's a thing where when salesmen sell cars, there's going to be paperwork where I have to look up the vehicle, and on the system, I have to go the what they call a stock number, so that way there's not duplicates of numbers, and so I have to do that, and also there's a thing called a dealer trade where I have to switch vehicles from ours to another dealer. So for example, if I have to go to San Diego to switch a vehicle, I have to do that and I have to fill in all the paperwork and print it out and put it inside the binders of the sales office.
How long are your shifts?
My shifts are 9 hours long and I get 1 hour breaks. But recently I've been going to school, so my hours have been cut short, so now I'm only working 7 hours a day.
And do you need to go to college in order
to be a porter? To be a porter, you do not need to go to college. Also, you also don't need to go to college to be a salesman, at least as I know.
Thank you.
Put it back in here. Like Camry, if we sold Camry, if this one is empty, we're going to put another one on it. So pretty much we have to replace
what we just sold on it.
Yeah. And we have our own specific garage where we hold
this
our
is the front area. The one people go.
This is the entrance. And as of right now, we're going to be driving to the top to get or to look at some
cars. You take picture on that side, yeah, right? Or no?
We could.
So we're going to go to the top and go to the PERMA and PDI cars.
PDI and PERMA is pretty much they're cleaning new cars off of the delivery truck.
Yeah.
Straight from the factory.
So yeah, the one we getting cars over here, we put it over here in the bottom.
So
we call it this down lot, and the other one is top lot.
Yeah.
That means front line in there, and that one is top lot. Yeah.
We're constantly running back and forth to fill in the lot as soon as we can. If not, our manager's looking mad at us, or they'll call us saying that we need to fill in the lot because it's empty.
Yeah, that's right.
Then we walk around, we go to the manager and tell them they need to bring that car to the service. Because if the bar is dead, if the bar is dead every day, that's what you need to bring to the service. So this is gonna be a tapla. They call it tapla. Not laptop. So this section right here, we hold half of the portion of the cars we have.
Yeah.
Like we have cars over here, almost like 300 cars over here. We have trucks, SUVs. So we need like a rob port to bring it to the front line. This is all the rob port right here. This is all the lot for the new cars.
This is all new cars right here. We hold a lot of cars in here.
It's only used car right here.
It looks pretty jam-packed, I know.
Here's the PDI line.
This is where they clean all the new cars off of the delivery truck.
Yeah. The one that just came, this right here. Here's the coma area.
Here are the trucks.
The same thing with the trucks. And we need some car trucks over there. We get them from here and put it over there. And this is the Highlander.
We have the SUVs.
The SUV and everything, yeah. So, pretty much that's it. But I cannot bring you to the Abbott because
all customers are like a family.
You know, a lot of gas in there.
Yeah.
Oh, we got prime over here. I can like that one. I need that in the front, so I can get that one and bring it to over there, so the salesman can sell it. So pretty much that's it. It's easy job.
It's a pretty easy job.
Yep. Coming in, coming out, like in and out.
That's about it.
So yep. Pretty much you have to wait for your break lunch.